Good morning, friends. Now, today's topic is related with the how to find two unknown frequencies. Generally, last four lectures we have completed related with the mean. So, direct method already we have completed, assumed mean method already we have completed, and step deviation mean also we have completed. But today we want to discuss here with the two unknown frequencies. One unknown frequency already we have completed the lecture. So, in two unknown frequency, today's topic related with it. So first of all, we go through the class. When class is given, already is always class and frequency is given in a question. So class 10 to 20, 20 to 40, 40 to 60, 60 to 80, and 80 to 100. Five class are given. Now frequency. So that is 17, F1, 32, F2, and 9. It means what I have to find? I have to find out these two unknown frequency, that is F1 and F2, two unknown frequency I have to find out. Now already we have learned in the last lecture that when unknown frequency we have to find out, always take A from Xi where unknown frequency is there. In Gujarati what we have said, Xi ni je value hoi, A kyare levani jhare unknown frequency hoi ini same. So first of all, how to find out Xi, that is important for us. What is given in question, always remember what is given in question. So sigma Fi, or we can say X bar is given first, that is given in a question always, that is 50. Afterward N, or we can say sigma Fi, it is also given, that is 120. Two things always given. When two unknown frequency if we have to find out on that time, always remember that mean is always given, n, that is number of frequency, that is sigma Fi, it is always given, n, class is also given, frequency is also given. What we have to find out? First of all, Xi we have to find out. So how we can find out Xi? Already we know. We can find out. So 0 plus 20 divided by 2. Again 10. 20 plus 40 divided by 2. 60 divided by 2 means 30. Afterward what I am saying to you, you have to check how much difference is there. 10 afterward 30. 20 difference is there. So I have to add 20, 20, 20, 20. So 30 plus 20, 50. 50 plus 20, 70, 70 plus 20, 90. Now second step, first step, first of all what we have to do, always do unknown frequency by step deviation method, always do by step deviation, always. If you want to do unknown frequency, when two unknown frequency we have to find out, on that time always do by step deviation method. So class, frequency, again total frequency is given, how much? 120. Now what I have to do, first add all these. So F1 and F2 is remain as it is, 17 plus 32, 7 plus 2, 9, 9 and 9, 18, 8, carry 1, 1 plus 1, 2, 2 plus 3, that is 5, 5 plus 1, 6. So F1 plus F2 plus 68 is equal to 120, because 120 total is given. Now F1 plus F2 plus 68 is equal to 120. So F1 plus F2 is equal to 120 minus 68. So F1 plus F2 is equal to 52. It means when if you have find out the answer F1 and F2, your answer must be total 52. Whatever you will get value of F1 and F2, it is always sum is equal to 52, otherwise you have got wrong answer. Now you have to go further by step deviation method. In step deviation we know that we have to take ui. So always ui is equal to what? Ui is equal to xi minus a upon h. Ui is equal to xi minus a. Xi minus a, a means what? Always we have take from Xi. Where we have to put a? Whereas unknown frequency is there, on same it. It means Xi we have to take 30. But where we have to take 30 as a? where fi is their unknown frequency is there.
So here always we know that 0 above, minus, below, plus,
0, 1, 2 and 3. Now next step, what we have to do? Fi xi. So always multiply, we have to multiply with 17 into 1, that is minus 17, 32 into 1, that is 32, f2 into 2, that is 2f2, 19 into 3, that is 57. Now what the students are doing mistakes, mostly, they add 2 in the numbers. We cannot do it like any add karai, nahi. First of all, what we have to put? We have to put plus 2f2 as it is. Afterward, you have to total it. So 57 minus 17, that is 40. 40 plus 32, that is 72. So over sigma fi ui is equal to 72 plus 2f2. Now all the values already we have given. Sigma fi, that is 120. Fi ui already we have found out, 72 plus 2f2. Now whatever we have to put the value, that first we have to write. We have to write the value, that is a h sigma fi and sigma fi ui. Now formula for step deviation, x is equal to a plus h, that is height, multiplied by sigma fi ui upon sigma fi. 50 is equal to 30 plus h, that I am written last, 20. 72 plus 2f2. Now first of all, what we have to shift? 50, 30 shift. So 50 minus 30, that is 20. 72 plus 2f2, here we have to make cancel as a 26 are 120. Now this 6 should be multiplied with 20. So 20 into 6, that is 120. 120 is equal to 72 plus 2f2. So 72 again we have to shift. We have to shift. 120 minus 72, that is 48. So 2f2 is equal to 48. f2 is equal to 24. So one value we have get, that is f2 is equal to 24. Now we know that sum of two frequency f1 plus f2 is equal to 52. That already we know. It means we have to put one value related with the equation. So it's a one type of equation, f1 plus f2 is equal to 52. So I have to put 24 right here. So f1 plus 24 is equal to 52. f1 is equal to 52 minus 24, that is 28. Again, we can check our answer that we are correct or not. What you have to do? You have to add this. You have to add this 24 and 28 at here. Then you have to get anyhow 120. Then it means your answer is correct. It's a board sum. Again, I repeat, what is our topic? We are doing unknown frequency f1 and f2. Two unknown frequencies are given. And if we have to find out the unknown frequency, then always first what we have to method use, that is called step deviation method, that we have to use. Another thing is that whenever unknown frequencies are there in frequency f1 and f2, either you have to take a at here, it means from xi either you have to take a at here or you have to take a at here. That is important for us. Now one more sum, that is in board 2014 ask, that again I am doing it here. So one more sum if you will do, then it will make more practice to us. So first of all, again what is given, that is important for us. So I am writing CBSE board 2014 sums I am explaining it here. Now one sixty to one eighty, 180 to 200,
200
to 220 and 220 to 240.
So that is given 1, 2, 3, 4, 8, 5 class are there. Now frequency that is 0, 5, 25, F1, F2 and 5. What is given that is important for us? X bar, sigma Fi. So X bar is given as a 188. So X bar is equal to 188. Sigma Fi, or we can say N, it is also given, that is 100. Now we have to find out two unknown frequency. So first, what is our first step? We have to find out Xi. So how we can find out Xi? 150, 160 plus 180 divided by 2. 160 plus 180, that is 340. 340 divided by 2, that is 170. So what is different? 20. Again I add 20, 190. Again I add 20, 210. Again I add 20, 230. Already we know that anywhere we have to assume A, but where we have to assume A? Either F1 or F2. So I have assumed A at here. Now how you find out Xi? Ui is equal to Xi minus A upon H. So always we remember here it is 0. Here minus 1, minus 2. Here 1 and 2. Now we have to find out Fi Xi. 5 into 10, that is minus 10. Minus 25. Here it is 0. Here it is F1. Here it is 10. So this cut. So F1 minus 25. That is over sigma Fi Ui. Now where we have to go first? We have to total it. F1 plus F2. Plus 25 plus 5, that is 30, 30 plus 5, 35. So here 35 is equal to 100. So F1 plus F2 is equal to 100 minus 35, that is 65. So we have to remember that F1 plus F2 is equal to 65. Your answer must be total 65. Now we have to go through the formula, that is X bar is equal to A plus H into sigma Fi Ui into sigma Fi. So X bar, that is given 188, A 190, H difference 20. Fiui, F1 minus 25 upon 100 into 20. Sigma Fi is given 100. If I will shift at here, that is minus 2. 20 Fi is F1 minus 25 upon 5. I have to shift at here. Minus 10 is equal to F1 minus 25. So F1 is equal to 25 minus 10, that is 15. Now we have to check it is F1 or F2. Again, if we are doing mistake, then here it is F2. So here what we have to write? F2. So here we have to write F2. So F2 value is 15. Now we know that F1 plus F2 is equal to 65. If I will put 15, then F1 is equal to 65 minus 15, F1 is equal to 15. So two values we have get, that is F1 and F2, and total is 65. Again I explained, two unknown frequencies are there, class is given, unknown frequency we have to find out. So wherever unknown frequency is there, F1 from xi we have to take as a, because it will always come to 0. And so xi, ui, fi, xi, write all the value. If you, it's a 4 marks weighted sum or 3 marks. So if you put the value, x bar is given, that is 188, sigma fi is 100, x is equal to a plus h, sigma fi ui upon sigma fi. If you put all the value, we can get value of F2, and then we can get value of F1. So this is the last lecture related with the mean. I think 14.1 you have to complete now, because all type of sums we have discussed. Now in next lecture we go to either mean or mode.